Hello, and welcome to the VSDC channel. What comes to your mind when you hear the word nostalgia? Maybe it's the iconic video games of the 90s, sweet taste of bubblegum, or perhaps those unmistakable VHS tapes. And today, in this video, we will show you how to make a VHS effect to transport you back in time and capture that old-school vibe. So let's jump right in. First of all, let's customize our workspace. Close unnecessary windows and resize the others for more convenience. If you accidentally lose something important, no worries. Just retrieve it from the View menu or use the Panes Manager. Now, let's get our videos onto the timeline. To create our VHS effect, we will introduce film noise, tweak the color of our frames, and simulate that classic camera shake. Let's start with adding noise. Select the first video and navigate to the Editor tab, Video Effects, Special FX, TV, Aging TV. Stretch the effect over the entire file and then set Scratches number to 1 in the properties and keep the Use Color Aging property enabled. Continuing with our VHS effect, we will add more texture by introducing additional noise and stripes. Here's how to do it. Editor, Video Effects, Special FX, TV, Random Dot Stereo TV. After adding this effect, we change transparency to 5% and set Method 2. To add some dynamics to the background, open the key editor for the stride parameter. For those using the free version of the software, opt for linear parameter change and set the first key to 300 and the last one to 700. If you are working with the Pro version, you can make use of the sine wave template. Select Templates. If you do not see this button, stretch the window or click on the two down arrows and select Sinusoid. Then adjust the minimum and the maximum values between 300 and 700 to create a sinusoid. Next, let's enhance the frame style by adding Gaussian blur. In the properties, set blur level to 10. For animation of the blur parameters on the X and Y axis, free users should set X to 25 and Y to 15 without animation. Pro users can again utilize the sine wave template for this animation. Now you can see all the settings on the screen. Let's check out our progress. It's already looking nice, but there is one important point: the aspect ratio of the frame. It should be either 3 to 4 or 1 to 1 to really capture that vintage VHS aesthetic. Let's dive into how to achieve this in both the Pro and the free versions of the software. Let's start with the Pro. Select the Rectangle tool. It's great for rounding the edges and draw the area of the frame. If you are aiming for a 3 to 4 ratio in Full HD, adjust the parameters as shown on the screen or select the 1 to 1 option. Next, change the color of the rectangle to black and slightly round the edges. Within the rectangle, add Gaussian blur with blur level set to 15 and 30 and select Extend the boundaries. Change the blending mode of the rectangle to inverted mask. Voila! It looks fantastic! If you have the free version, masks are not available. To achieve a similar result, add the cropping effect. Select Crop Mode, Crop Borders, and adjust the crop border. Now, at scene 0, we select all the videos and create a sprite. and adjust it to show effects. Go back into the sprite and add the camera shake effect. This requires a free virtual dub plugin available from infognition.com. The download link is in the video description. Navigate to Virtual Dub Filters DB under Video Effects, then MSU Old Cinema and download the effect. In VSDC, go to Video Effects, Special FX, Virtual Dub Filter. And in the properties, select the downloaded file. Click on Configure Plugin to customize the effect, where you will find 12 presets to choose from. Select the one that best suits your project. Now, let's move on to the color adjustment and add the color grading effect inside the sprite. In the color grading window, adjust the video temperature to 50, contrast to 5, brightness to 15, while reducing the saturation to 60. For a touch of flare, let's introduce some magenta into the light colors. Next, fine-tune the visuals by adjusting the curves. Trim the light and the dark tones, elevate the green level, and reduce the blue level to achieve that distinct vintage look. Looks amazing! For a final touch, let's add a vignette. Draw an ellipse and place it beneath the color grading layer. Choose black as the fill color and place Gaussian blur inside it. With blur level set to 200. Set the blending mode for the ellipse to inverted mask. Or for the free, the destination atop option also gives a similar result. Adjust the position and size of the ellipse and the vignette is ready. Now, simply copy all these effects from the first video to the remaining videos in your project. And voila! You've successfully recreated that nostalgic VHS effect. If you found this video helpful, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. See you next time!